In this demo, I'm going to go over the basics of the crop tool. And in Photoshop, cropping is kind of like holding a photo in your hands, taking a pair of scissors and cutting around the outer edges to trim off stuff that you don't want. So I'm going to go to File and Open, and I'm going to open up Basic Cropping. And we have this simple family photo. Okay, if I don't have a lot of room here to work with, like I barely see space along the edges, I'm going to hit Command and Minus once. Now, if it zooms out too far, like that, I want somewhere in between, I can take my zoom tool, click and drag to the left or right to zoom in and out, and I'm going to zoom right about there. That looks a little more comfortable for me. Okay, the problem with this photo is twofold. Number one, you can see the bottom edge of the photo is straight. It's perfectly horizontal, but the walkway is not. So this photo is crooked. And second, my brother-in-law walked into the photo and kind of ruined it. So I want to straighten out this photo and get rid of this guy. All I have to do is click once on the crop tool, and it will automatically set a boundary around your photo. Okay, if I have a long horizontal edge like this, I can come right up here, right next to the word straighten is a level tool, like a construction worker's level. So I'm going to click on that, and it's a measuring device. I'm going to put the little plus right on the edge of the walkway, click and drag like a really long tape measure. You can go way over here. Longer the line, it's easier to adjust the angle. And I'm going to line it up right along that walkway there. So what Photoshop is going to do is when I let go of the mouse, it's going to rotate this photo at the opposite angle, straightening out the photo. Now, if I really wanted to see if that's straight, right next to the word crop or straighten, which we're using with the crop tool, sorry, right next to the word straighten is your grid, your rule of thirds, your overlays. See, the default is rule of thirds. It divides your composition into three columns and three rows. Well, I want more lines, so I'm going to go to the grid. And I can see that this walkway is pretty darn parallel with that grid. That looks pretty good right there. Okay, all the area around here, the area that is shaded a little darker, is about to be deleted. What's darker is going to be deleted. Okay, what I want to do is get rid of this guy. So I'm going to go to the side and just pull that in right about there. So we just get him in the shaded area. He's about to be deleted. Now the other problem is when I pulled this side over, the family unit here has gone kind of off center. So I'm going to come back up to my grid overlay and come back to the rule of thirds. You can switch it while you're working. And I'm just going to notice that the family unit doesn't exactly line up in this center column. So I'll just pull the right side over until we're pretty much centered in this composition, and that looks good. And I can also see since I pulled this side, I have a little bit more room down here at the bottom, so I'll just pull that edge down just so it's inside the boundaries of the photo. You don't want any little white space here. And that photo looks good, so all I have to do is hit return, and there we go. One photo cropped. Done, ready to be turned in for credit. So that is the basics of the crop tool.